There are lots of ways to customize your binder to make it uniquely yours, and all of those are under this button called Settings. This is also where you'll find your binder name and description, and these can be changed at any point in time. If you go to Colors, you will see that you'll be able to change the tab color, the main tab color, the sub-tab color, and if you have a subscription, you can change the base tab colors too. So all you do is click on this, select a color that you want, click on OK, and it changes your tabs. You can set a background color as well. And a subtab color too. You can also change the layout in your binder. What you may have noticed, I'm going to get out of this menu for a minute and go into View Play mode. And in this mode, this is how other people will see your binder. There's always a default first page of the binder called an overview. And then your individual tabs and subtabs. Let's go back to edit mode. And that overview will also have your binder cover in it. So if we go here, back to binder settings, click on binder cover, you can upload an image if you've got an image that you want to upload. Or you can search images on Flickr. And just grab an image from Flickr for your binder cover, which is always an easy way to go. So let's go back to layout. You can have your tabs on the top, or you can have them scrolling on the top. You can have them on the left side or the right side. My preference is side tabs on the left, and especially when you have a lot of tabs, this is just looks better. Now you're not going to see these options on layout in the edit mode, but you will see it in play mode. You can also have a table of contents as your first or second tab, or not displayed at all. You can also get rid of that overview tab if you didn't like it. So let's take a look and see what this is going to look like in play mode. Okay, so here it is. You can see I've got tabs on the side here. I've got the table of contents as my second tab. I've got the overview, which now has my pretty little picture in it, and my custom colors. So those are my layout options. If you have an upgraded account, you can also change the shape of the tabs, and you can also turn off some of the other things that are available in the play mode. Let me show you that. So if you click on this little hamburger menu, you can see that there are all these things like add to shelf or copy or see more binders like this or see featured binders. You can remove all that if you have a paid account. So that is how you customize your binder.